Hello and welcome to Dell's Gaming. I'm Dell and you join me here in my testing area of From the Depths. This is the designer and we're on my little test pontoon. And we're going to just do some missile tests. After the, I thought I'd just do a quick lab video on missiles after our little incursion with a fast vessel. So, to get down to it, our situation is we have a fast vessel. It could be flying, could be shipborne. I've set up a little test area here, which has a high speed, and we're talking around 90 or plus meters a second speed, and we have to attack it with a missile. Hopefully, missiles supposedly being fast. Fast things, you know, in real world obviously missiles go faster than just about anything because they're streamlined and small, etc. Right, so what have we got? We have a couple of different sizes of missiles. Now let me just turn the interface back on so I can see what we're doing. Now what I have done as a basis is said that we need at least one for every thruster, and also you would need target prediction. So the smallest possible missile on this three block missile would be this short range thruster, one fin, one fuel tank, target prediction. Because also if you're firing this from a vessel, really you'd want to go about 500 meters or so. So this here is the smallest, fastest missile I could make that has a chance of hitting another fast target. So if we just fire that one off and then follow the missile, there we go. So if you can see that, the speed there got up to 104 and the distance is around 500 meters. You'd ideally want around 500 meter distance as well before the fuel goes out. So yes, about 500 meters. We'll ignore the distance from after the fuel. So yep, that's not too bad. That would work as a potential, but it's only got one warhead in these, so that's a three block missile getting up to the right speed. It's still, if it was chasing a ship going 19 meters a second, it wouldn't catch it up, because this has to accelerate up to that speed. It's not starting at 19 meters a second, it has to accelerate up to that speed. So therefore this would be okay if it was coming in or passing, but it couldn't chase down a vessel going at 90 meters a second. So let's try and see what else we can do. So this is a four block missile with two thrusters, two fins, and the one fuel tank, one warhead, again infrared. So we'll just give that a quick go and let's see where we get with this. And there we go, we got up to 100, it was about 106, but the distance, we only got up to barely 300 meters before the engine run out. But it did get up to a good speed, but no faster than the three block, to be honest. So okay, we're getting it got a little faster, maybe about the same speed, but certainly the range was severely dented because of the only the one fuel tank. Okay, what else could we do here? Right, so let's go up to give it the extra fuel tanks on a five block missile. So we're just trying this on a five block, see if we can get in between. So five blocks firing away. So speed, yes, getting up to 92, but it has got a good seven, it was about 650 range, so a 92. So five blocks does look like a good reasonable interceptor missile on that there. Needed the extra fuel tanks, needs the fins, a little slower so it couldn't chase a 90 down. So let's just try this. This is a six block missile, so we've added an extra thruster and an extra fin, extra fuel tanks, and let's just see where we can get to on here. So this is number four, so this is a six block missile. So we're doing a load of testing here. And speed 94, and about 500. So not really any faster on that one there. And finally our eight block missile. Let's see what we can do with an 8-block missile. So 4 thrusters, 4 fins, and fuel tank, 1 warhead. So just see what we can do with an 8-block missile. Let's give it a go. And speed, 80, only getting up to 83 there. 500 meters, 83. So it's at the limit of the range. So definitely diminishing level of return there on the larger missile. Okay, so that's generally a good interceptor type of missiles. Okay, let's look at this. There's another type of missile we could go for to try and do this. There's a couple of ways of doing this. So this is a dogfighting missile, short range dogfighting style missile. And of these, I'd most probably just stick with the 3-block missile here. So it's got reasonable, it's only got one fin, but it's also a small missile. It should move around relatively quickly. There is another type of missile we can go for, which is reduce the fins. Now I think on this one we're going to have too short a range, so we go for the fuel tank but no fin. So we're going to reduce the fins. This is like a I'm trying to think of an analogy. The current systems like Patriots and stuff like that, they just aim directly at it and they try to intercept it on the way in and just use sheer speed to get them at the right place at the right time, rather than any advanced maneuvering. So what we're doing here is I'm just basically giving this, we still want some range, but I'm giving this basically as much speed as I can. So we won't check the 3. So what I've done with the 4, the 3 we won't check because there's no real difference on that. So the 4, it's got the thruster and it's got that extra fuel. So let's just see what speed we can get on there, getting with that extra fuel tank. So fire, and okay, we're getting 112, that's good, and we get to the, about that 500, like 112. So that's potentially a good, so that's 112, that's our best so far as speed goes. And we still have to get 500 meters is our key factor still. So let's see, 5-block missile. So this has got 3 thrusters, 1 fin, so we're not going for any sort of maneuvering. This is being fired straight at a target, hopefully as it's coming into you. So let's just see what we can get on that one. 113, and about, yeah, got to the 500 meters. So I think if without fuel, if it gets to 600, we should be okay. So yeah, that's 113 for the 5-block missile. Still no real main advantage over the 4. So, oops, sorry, the 4 would still be potentially a good missile for this. Where do we get up to? 6-block missile. So 4 thrusters, 1 fin, hopefully enough tanks. Now obviously we haven't got a one turn on. I'll go through that in a second. Let's just go through one more hit, one more shot. See what we can do with this one, and go. So 110 distance, yeah, 500 again, 110, no real benefit over that. I can't reduce the fuel anymore because it won't have the range. So that's there. So okay, let's just go with the 8 missile. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 thrusters, 1 fin, fuel tanks to get it to 500. Let's see if this will get to the 500 on the 8-block missile. So this is our largest sort of interceptor missile as such, and let's see how we go with that. 102, it started off very quickly at a good high speed, 102, and just made it. Yeah, so okay, of these interceptor missiles, it maybe the 4 is possibly the best missile in this case. I would just fire that one more time to confirm that. We need to get 500 meters and a good speed, but we're not worried about accuracy. So there we go, 113, and it got the good 500 meters. Okay, not bad at all. We'll just compare that back to the original three block missile. So that's getting up to, takes a little slower to get up to speed, 102. So that's the thing. So okay, so of the, if you're going for a, let's call it an interceptor missile. Now an interceptor missile is a missile that aims at a target that's coming in to you. As such, so it's got a quick, it's just hopefully they're heading in towards you rather than away. So they're not chasing, they're hoping to, you're hoping to catch it. So the four block missile, although it's only got one warhead, is potentially the best option in that regard, but it's got very, it has only got short range. There is one other type of missile that is possible, and there is a system that I worked on which is using the three blocks. So if you're just doing high speed and wanting maneuverability, so chasing, it looks like the three block missile could be the best. It's going to have a good maneuverability with the one fin. I'm just looking through, seeing if I can improve that in any way, any of these. I don't think I'm going to, if I put that fin out, we'll just try four thrusters on this one. That's the five block missile, just to see if we can get that speed up on that five block and still have the 500 meter range. Oh, that got up to 128, but the range, look at that range. Terrible range on that, but we did get up to about 130. So if you're willing to sacrifice the range significantly, you could go with this five block. So that's the fastest we've gone so far, and we'll just try the same on here. One more thruster on this block, just see if it can match up on the six. And we've got up to 122, but again, the range is not as bad, but the range is definitely not good. And we know the eight has got, once you get up to a certain size, that it's a diminishing return, unfortunately. It just cannot compete with that. So 120 was actually the best one on this five, but that range, that's not good. Now the other issue we've got is these don't have a one turn, so they would be have to be within the 45 degrees of your target. So ideally, either you've got to be pointing at your target, heading towards it in an aircraft is one way, or you've got to be on a turret. So that would be the two ways to basically get your weapon on target. Now, one other bit is you don't want to be chasing the target. If you've got a... in a chase scenario, your maximum speed is regularly, they normally work it as half of your actual speed, because you have to allow for acceleration and then terminal velocity, and your target has that initial speed and is continuing on. So you would generally need double at least the speed of your target. So we haven't got anything that's got up to a 180 meters a second. So on a 90 meter target, we'd have to fire these at about 100 meter range for to catch up with a 90 meter target. I would say maybe 150 meter range you'd have to fire these at if you're in a chase scenario, so chasing up behind a enemy, so which is not really feasible. Might do it in a plane, but okay. So I have created one other system as a possibility. Now this is using the three block missile, the simple three block, and just lots of them. So 16 here with a short delay, no one turn. So with what we're going to do is just see how the AI uses this. Now, I haven't got a really fast, this is, you'd have to have these either in some way that they point at the particular target, or different batteries for different classes of vehicles. So this one, for instance, would be an anti-air, designed for anti-air vehicles. So let me just launch a air target, a relatively fast. He's not amazingly fast, but he's a fast enough. I think this Jet 2, actually, let me just make sure he is launched by pointing up in the air. Jet 2 into the deep water guard. There we go. It should zoom off. So if he does actually fire, but it's fairly low. So his speed, he's up to about 80. His velocity is up to about 80 meters a second. I assume that's 80 meters a second. So he will turn around and then come back. And we'll just see him. So he goes, slows down in his turn. It's not that stable a vehicle. It's just a quick little vehicle I put together for as a target. He does fire a couple of missiles, but he's nothing amazingly special. He's coming in. He's a bit slow when he's coming in. There he goes for a dive, and he does go down a little bit faster, 60s, 70s, so 75 meters a second. So he's relatively fast, not ultimately fast. So now if we enable our anti-air system, so what we've done is we've set it at only 250, it'll only fire at 250, and also when the minimum altitude you'd need to set on this to be minimum altitude, maximum you'd obviously also want to be at 250, because it can't fire at anything further, maybe about 400, yeah, 250, we'll set at 250 anyway. You can see that he does come in within that range. Just actually, he doesn't actually, so we now have to set that at 400. Remembering these missiles did have a 500 meter range, so they should be able to go up, but then we got to reduce our vertical range to be within 200. Minimum altitude, that's the wrong one, my apologies. We need to set our, make sure that he does actually come within range. So he's coming within range, and is he within the vertical? So he's within range there, and his vertical, he's actually higher than our target. No, he's diving in. Okay, so we would be able to capture him. Okay, so we can get him in his dive moment. He would get to launch on us. So now we'll just activate this. And on his next dive pass, so these are sitting here waiting for a target that fits within that target envelope now. So less than 400 meters high, within 250 meters, and these are fairly quick moving missiles, but they don't have a one turn, so just remember there is no one turn on these missiles at this time. So let's just see how these fire off. Hopefully they should fire at the target once he is within range. And no, they didn't. Now, did he not get within the range profile there? I will let's just put that on no limit. Maximum range. Oops, he possibly didn't get into the maximum range there because of his height. So we don't have to change that to 350. So we have to be very specific here that he's a little higher flying than I would like. But that's fine. You could have these for, you can define it. Let's just see if 350 will get him. Remember, this isn't as a maximum speed vessel. And on there, no, did not catch him. So in that environment, it would not catch. So all those missiles would miss in that for this target against this is only a 70 speed vessel. Let's see if we can get him on the second pass. So there's certainly not a guaranteed hit. So when he's coming back in, we'll just see what he does this time. So what we're doing, what I'm showing here, is there is a limitation with missiles against ships. Ships can be better than missiles. You've got to be very specific. Okay, so he's coming in at about 80. Did we get him that time? Again, no chase. So what we're gonna have to do is take a fire a little earlier in this environment. So we'll set it at 450, which is close to the missile's maximum range. So what we're gonna do is hoping that we'll actually do a more like an interceptor missile. So we'll try to get him on his way in rather than his way out in this regard, which is very similar to like the Patriot style. So they try to get him when they're far out, but they have to fire further than their actual ranges. Oops, did I change something there? Because he didn't fire at all there. Oops, I changed the channel on the radio by accident. We'll get him on next time, on the next turn. So yes, we're now acting more like a interceptor missile, for want of a better word, in that we're doing a fire at further than our actual range. We can't define whether a vessel is coming towards us or going away. We can only define that he is within a particular range profile. So hopefully we're doing a fire now whilst he is diving in. Somewhere in that region. Come on, there we go. So he's a little bit above, but now our target prediction can now luckily get him. Once he's obviously there, we've got a nice second volley firing out. So this is an example of a good possible interceptor that you could do. There is one other design which we will just put in, and I'll come back within the sector, which is the true interceptor style, and we're going to use this 5-block missile here, which did go up to we'll check on that. I think the 5-block was the best one here. If we just check that out here again. Yes, 400 meters. Yep, okay, and it got up to a really good speed. So, and it got there quickly. So we're gonna set this up as a proper interceptor. So I will be back shortly with a second version. And welcome back. And what I've got here now, just to show, is like a more directed missile system. So what we have here is a torqueless turret, a 360 degrees turret, on top of a fire control with a 5-block missile. So this, it could be a 4-block. I do use 5-block on here just to get a little extra range. So this is a design to take on aircraft at range or as they're coming in. Now, key parts on this are the range of the maximum range here is actually more than the actual missile can do. The missile can only do 500, but he's aiming to catch vehicles as they're coming in, hopefully, and therefore their speed as they're coming forward will work with us. The other important factor is in the accuracy here. In the actual control block, I've set the accuracy fairly low, 15, to ensure that the turret is actually pointing at the vehicle before it tries to fire. So we'll just let this go out and simulate it coming in for its first attack run on us. So we'll just let that one go out, that jet. So if I now turn on the AI, this will now be active. So it should now try and fire at this on its way in when it's around the 900 meters away mark. And it's got a high speed missile with, well, I've put a fragment actually into it now rather than an explosive, but it could have a warhead. But the aim is to aim at the target as close as we can within that 15 degrees of its predicted target, fire in, and we get a hit. So that's a more of an interceptor missile as such. Yes, it only got one target, and you still got to hope you hit a vital area. The way I've set this up is it only would target air targets. I think this would also still be a valid system. And this is more of a take them once they're close, but this one can get them a little further away. As you can see, it's got that 900 range. You could put, say, a bank of three on here rather than just a single missile. But it's because it's intercepting on their way in, it seems it will have a much better chance of hitting. If it tries to, you don't want this missile to be too long, otherwise it will take too long to reload. You also want to make sure that you have your accuracy set up here so that it only attacks certain targets. Now you can have, you could duplicate this up. We could have, if we just do it very quickly, if I just create a second one here, I think that should still be controlled. Yeah, we've got now got two. They'll have a bit of a fight, so they won't be ideal, but now we've got two, well, only one hit. Okay, that's fine, but we've got two. This one should try to... Oh no, they did hit enough just to take it down. So that was excellent. So in this case, and now his normal weapons should start firing. So that was like a little interceptor type missile. Now obviously, the only issue with this one, I do like this, and I might put some of these actually on, say, the carrier, I think. The only issue I've got with these is that they do freak out a little bit, some of these torqueless turrets. They do spin around quite incessantly, but that's an alternative way. It's an aim. So the key parts here are on this missile control, change this accuracy down. If you don't change that down, as soon as it gets within 900, it will fire. And because there's no one turn and the accuracy will be off, you're just never going to hit anything. So the keys are, it's firing when it's this is set to further than the missile range, 900, when this missile is only 500. What you'd also set potentially, we can't set it here. What I would do is set up a separate AI whose target prioritization is fast targets. So a level 2 AI is close range, fast targets. And that's about its only thing, and mainly for speed. It would target prioritize targets based upon speed, so that these do not try and fire at a target that's not worth. We want them to be the point defense system. Anyway, hopefully this has been useful, looking at missiles. Overall, I would say that missile speeds, considering that we're getting vehicle speeds up to something like there's people talking about 250 mile an hour planes now. Considering we're getting vehicles up to that speeds, I think missiles theoretically should need a buff of some description to be able to do a similar sort of speed levels. A aerodynamic small little missile like these should theoretically be able to go faster than a quite complex jet like that over there, especially with a solid fuel booster of some description. So whether we need a new booster block or some way of overcharging it to get the speed, but not range doesn't, I don't think, needs a boost. We can get out to 2000 with the right block, but speed potentially should need a buff of some description. Otherwise, basically, I don't want to say this again, but basically you'll end up with lasers, and everybody will just have lasers, and it will be lasers from the depths, which is just no fun, you know. We need to allow other things to have a chance against some of these targets as well. There is good plus points about missiles, don't get me wrong. But yeah, we need them to be usable in a campaign and situation as people are going up level, so that it isn't just the going for just having one type of weapon system that every vehicle has. That's my personal opinion on missiles, because I do like missiles and I like to see them be pushed forward in this game. But until next time, hopefully you found this useful or interesting, or just, I don't know, just interesting to see the game development. But until next time, keep playing and have fun.